We good? We good to go? Title, you're reading it differently? Wait, what? What did I put the title as? Did I fuck something up here? No, that's what I meant to put. Yeah, no real funny title today. Okay, so next member of the World 3. Let's start with the young woman. So last time I got into the like secret internet base of World 3, which I don't know why they'd have their base on the internet, since anyone could reach it. But I have to find like these passcodes and shit to get in there. I got one. Well, I got two technically last time. Now I have to find two more. One from an old guy and one from a young woman. And I believe the young woman... Actually, no, I don't. I'm not saying I believe. I know who the young woman and the old man already are. But, you know, just for exploration's sake, let's say I don't. And let's assume that someone around here knows where to look. He a World 3 member? Must be joking. However, I did meet a man who knows a lot about them. I think he said he lives in AC/DC town. www. Yeah. It's a Japanese laugh. They're having a giggle. Nah, but it's like... they do that a lot. It's like the comic company Jump. Whenever they write themselves... Like, whenever they write their logo, it's just like a J. But people know that... In Japan, know that when they just see a capital J, they know it means... It stands for Jump. Because it's like a brand, almost. It's like a logo rather than just a letter. You think that I'm an ex-member of the World 3, huh? Let me see that navi you got there. Well, no point in pretending to be senile anymore. Yes, I was a member at the beginning, as Wily's assistant. Yes, I know how to release the lock up to the undernet, but... First, there's one more ex-World 3 member you should see. You must save her. A young beauty she is.
Well... But who is she?
Miss Mari's the only teacher left here. Maybe it's Miss Mari. Me, a former World 3 a former member of World 3. See, it says of the WWW sounds more correct than the World 3. But I don't like saying WWW because it takes a long time. You've got to be kidding. But I guess that I am young and beautiful. Just kidding, just kidding. Maybe I should go take a rest. That song stuck in my head. I've had this song stuck in my head for like a couple days now, and I can't remember what it was. Something, 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 something. Something, 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 something. You see my child got separated? Yes, I've seen your child. She's like another block away. High gear, plot, yeah, blah blah blah, and I'm back on the same side. Me, an ex-member of the World 3, ha! Let me see that navi of yours, ha! I've been waiting for a net battle like you up here. I've been playing the fool to hide from them. Sure, I know how to undo some of the locks. Let me check your data library. I suppose that you're ready now. Here's how to open the lock. Got Yuri memo. Oh man, is that like... notes about that new anime or whatever, Yuri on Ice? I have faith that you could stop the World 3.
Huh.
Oops. Looks like that's become a habit. The fact that I have a twin is one of the reasons that I was able to become a World 3 leader. I'm not sure why that is, however. Me neither. That's really weird. I actually don't know if this game will last the entire stream, or the stream will last 3 hours, just because I have nothing planned after this. And I don't know how long this is going to take. Let me see that nav of yours one more time. Well, I guess that you may be strong enough now. Here. Got pause memo. Perhaps the one to stop the endgame will be you, Lan, and not a Psylab net battler. I didn't like the way that Wily wants to run things. That's what got me kicked out. He used to be a good guy, though. Oh, we're getting lore. So we got the two memos, and now I just gotta figure out where to... Can I get back to that area? I think going in through the pot, or whatever, the magnifying glass, or whatever, is the quickest way. Maybe I'll fight her again, just to... This Wowie was good too, maybe. The truth is, there's a lot to his backstory that gets revealed in later games. Wait, why'd I do that? I was gonna fight her. We'll be finding a little more about Wily in a short while. A short Wawile. Alright, that didn't work. Nice. Schoolman. I believe this big skull attack on one enemy. Yeah, that's actually a pretty good thing. I'll replace Gutsman with that. There's actually higher versions. Like, see how I have roll 2? You could actually get up to 3 for each of these, for every Navi in the game. That's generally consistent among all the games, though they did change it in 4 and 5 to be like... There's like an irregular version, then an SP version, and then there's a DS version, and you can only use the DS one under certain circumstances. Just use Skullman. Test this card out. I think he just homes in on one enemy. Because he throws his head up. Yep. Shit. Yeah, that one. This one heals when it hits you. There it is. That's where we need to go. This just leads back to the exit, though. Or not. This is gonna be frustrating, I can already tell. This volume's really low. Is it low on your end, like the game volume, or just... or does it sound normal? Because on my end, the game volume's pretty damn low. A little bomb. Yeah, I think I have to go back this way. Really? It didn't even hit it? Unbelievable. Fuck. Uh-oh. Oh, the spaces don't actually break unless until they hit it. In other games, if you move off the space before they hit it, they fall into nothing, and then that little shockwave doesn't happen. Yeah, they actually take priority over the breaking of the panels in this game. See, like, how they, when they leave the panel, it breaks. If the panel's already cracked and you move off of it, it's supposed to break, and anything that lands on it disappears. But not in this game. This game, the drop enemies actually take priority over it. I didn't know that. My charger's just a little faster than it is. I believe that's just a dead end right there. Yeah, random data. Shit. Oh, well, whatever. Those. Oh, I fucked this up. I don't heal. Oh no. Again. This is getting annoying. Quick 3 C. You don't belong here. Get over here. Get over. Did I already find the exit here? I can't remember. Okay, so we got a stronger bomb-throwing dude. And we got Bloodsucker and... Ugh. I'm remembering how much I hate this part of the game. Yeah, these guys, if they hit in the middle, you're kind of fucked. Because you can't dodge them at all. So they hit like, they throw like every space now, I think. Just really annoying. Alright, let's take these. Better safe than sorry. Let's save. That's one problem down. Ice cube. What's that up there? What's that down there? What's this over here? Well, that worked out good. It ran into two squares of the hitbox, so I got hit twice. Big bomb T. Let's ditch one of the little bombs for that. Net dealer? Hey Kim, wanna see my stash? I got no money, wow. Just like in real life. Give me that HP memory. Another big bombo. Those World 3 jerks set it up so you have to go through the- if you go through here, you can't get back. Sheesh. Well, I'm not gonna bother with that. Or am I? Let me save real quick, see what's through here. Does this lead anywhere, like, unique? World 3 server, it's not around. Oh wait, I've been here before. Entrance for- oh, I was actually able to get through from there. So it was literally just a one-way lock if you didn't have the memo, whatever. Those World 3 jerks went and encoded this area. Only high-ranking dudes can get in, sheesh. They think they're so bad. Lab memo. Yeah, there's a bit more exploring I could have done in the previous area, and probably in all these areas, but it's like, I don't even want to bother at this point. Because, I mean, you've seen the internet. What you see now is what this internet is. Drop down enemies. Yep. Oh boy, Wood Tower. I phased those chips out, like, hours ago. Oh, fuck. I didn't mean to encounter a boss, but we're doing it, I guess. Alright, number man, let's see what you can do. What are we gonna get? Something good? That's pretty good. These chip codes match. I honestly don't think it matters how well you do in the version 2 fights, because you always get the level 1 chip from them from it. Now, though, he'll randomly show up in this area, and this, if I remember, this is actually a really good chip to have, because it hits enemies automatically. But yeah, I just made this area harder for myself by going down this route, actually, because now he'll randomly show up. Not that it matters, he's a very easy boss. Sunny Wave S. I already have Dino Wave. Wait, what about the other one? Shockwave. I don't even have S of that, of course. Oh well. That's the way out. So what's over here? Money. Come on. Got him. Mega Man, try using the memo we got from Miss Yuri. Roger. Big Z. All right. Boop, 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 boop. Wow, that's a really early game enemy. Why is that here? I have no freaking clue where I'm going. That's why I hate the internet in this game. I'm not even wearing the wood armor anymore. Took it off. Remobit 1N. Great. Oh, this is hell. Fresh hell right here. Okay. Okay. Cloud H. Shouldn't it be Cloud S? Shit. Look at that ugly ass palette swap for that ghost. It's so bad looking. Ass. Alright. Where am I going? What the fuck am I doing? Oh boy, a Met Guard. I wonder if that kid thinks I'm actually gonna give him 30 Met Guard chips, because I'm totally not. Nice. Entrance for World 3 person to try. Remember, we got from the old mayor. Pause memo, gained access. Okay, we're in the last area now, I think. Wow, that's a lot of money. Sorry about that. It's cool, bro. This was a dead end. starting to get really bored with this. Okay. You know what this is making me want? This is just making me want Pokemon to come out already. Fuck, man. I wanna play some Pokemon. Right on 1D. Am I back where I started? Is this the right way to go? Where am I supposed to go? I don't know. Stop. 6 or 9s? Wait, what? What are you talking about? You mean the number at the end? E. Oh, the letter in the background. Yeah, it's supposed to be E. It's supposed to be like internet. E for electron, I don't know. Email. I thought you were talking about the letter that appears at the end of the busting level. Or the number. Typhoon E. Oh, this is a dead end. Good. Good, good game. Series boring. The internet in this game is terrible. It's definitely drags down the experience. They changed that noise after the first game. Soon, yes. One more day. Wait, no, one more day? 2 more days. I have to see if my GameStop's doing a midnight release. Oh wait, that wasn't enough to kill them. Oh, you fucks. Yeah, nah, pre-order bonuses suck. I just don't want to have... I just would like to get it at midnight tomorrow, Thursday, if possible, but... I don't know. I don't even know if I'm... Am I heading in the right direction, or... What? Fuck, man. This chip folder sucks, too. Nintendo's never been one to do big pre-order things, though, for their games. Not usually. Well, no, I guess that's not true. Some games. You fuck. Alright. God damn it. Oh, I'm back where I started again. Save me. Someone help me escape. That's 100 damage. Gurf gets some of the really nice merch. Yeah, for Sun and Moon, they definitely get some good shit. Don't they get, like the big, like, wood book or whatever it is or something? Or is that just available anywhere? I don't think that's a pre-order bonus, actually. But what the fuck if I know. Yeah, I need to escape. Escape? Didn't I come here already? Drain one. Drain-o. Wait, no. I think I haven't gone this way. Oh, thank God. Not lost anymore. Now don't recover. Don't recover. Here we go. How did you, letter U, get in here? And who are you? I am Mega Man. This dialogue is amazing. And what brings you to me, the Great Bomb Man? I'm here to get the World 3's net address. I know you've got it, so hand it over. No, that won't do. It's deletion for you. Mega Man, this guy isn't too bright. I don't think we have a choice. Battle routine set. Execute. Look at that weird internet behind him. Did I see the version exclusives? Yeah, didn't I tell you about them? I know which ones are exclusive to each version now, but I also know that there is a way to get some version exclusives in the other game without trading. Which I'm very curious about. Nope, no you don't. You ain't doing that. Oh, you fuck. Oh, come on! It's funny because I think... Well, actually, my version exclusives are split, like, in what I want. So it doesn't really matter, either way. Because I'm like, ah, some of the good ones I want are in Moon. But then it's like, well, the other good ones I want are in Sun. Yeah, I know, I only gave you a small list because it only included new Pokemon and Alolan forms. It didn't include, It didn't include all of the Ultra Beasts, and it didn't include any old Pokemon that are returning, which I don't really see the point in those being version exclusive since, you know, I'll just transfer them forward anyway. Now, don't do that. Don't use a mine. Alright, good. I did find out something interesting, which I don't know if I should say it out loud because it might be a spoiler, but it involves catching certain Pokemon in Sun and Moon. Namely, how much of certain Pokemon appear. He's easy as shit. He's just really annoying and slow. Here we go. Shit. Wait, don't tell me I used up my chip. Nope, it didn't. You're dead. But Bomb-Man is never defeated. Len, I've got the World 3's address. Then let's use it to break into the World 3's network. Fool, they don't call me Bomb-Man for nothing. Net bomb program activated. Uh-oh, Mega Man? And it's gone. You okay? Yeah, but... Oh no, the net's been closed off. Darn, we were so close. I'm sure we could use this address somehow. You're right, let's talk to Dad. Finally done with that horrid area. You got the best version, best exclusives. I would say I like Drampa. I want Drampa, and I want Lycanroc Midnight form. And I don't know what else. What else was exclusive? I do kind of like UBO2 in Moon better than Sun. But at the same time, I do really like Suns as well. But, is it the ones with stone Evo lines? What? Which ones are you talking about? Hikari is at his desk. Oh, Lan. Hey, Dad. You got a minute? Of course. Cool. Sorry I've been away so much. So how are you? Did you talk to Chaud? Talk to that jerk? Did you have a fight? He can be hard to deal with. Well, anyway, check this out. Lan used the at World 3. Lan, where did you get this? I got it with Mega Man. But we can't get through the network. I see. Well, with this, I'm sure we could find the World 3 labs. Are you sure? Sure. Should be no problem using our technology here. This may help us stop the war. Of course, I'll have to tell Chaud about this. Is that okay? I guess. Could you tell me the location, too? No. Why not? I'm the one who defeated the World 3, and with the Mega Man program that you created. Please, let us help finish the job. Lan. Finish the job. Okay, I give in. But one condition. The World 3's attacks will likely start coming even harder. Mega Man could be deleted, and your actions could trigger the war. Can you take that responsibility? You're right. I couldn't put my son in such danger. Maybe we should talk about this later. Oh, so you literally can't say no. It's a but thou must situation. Okay, I'll send you the location when we find it. And X and Y was annoying to find an Eevee. I don't know how hard it is to find an Eevee in Sun and Moon. I actually don't know which Pokemon are in it, aside from the new ones and the Alolan forms. I know Goodra is in there somewhere, but I already have one. But I do know that there are ways to get Pokemon that are A, not in your version, and B, not in the Pokedex either. I know that there are ways to get both of those. Thanks, Dad. I'll send you mail with the location. Go practice net battling. Now we just have to wait for Dad's mail. Want to head home? It's weird, but even the writing in this game feels like very stiff compared to the later games. Like, even Battle Network 2, if I ever stream that, you'll see that, like, the dialogue is way more realistic and less like, oh, let's do this, oh, this guy's a jerk, wow, I don't want to talk to him. I promise I'll be good if you let me go and fight in the war. Like the second game is a lot more lenient, or not lenient, a lot more open with its dialogue. Dad is never home. Wonder what's. Oh, I already read that.
Turn in for the day, yeah. Oh, yeah. I'm pretty fucking tired. Good night, lad.
Our address. Looks like the Psylab has got it. Our secret lab will be discovered in no time. No matter. Oh, shit, you're never supposed to touch those together. Oh god, what are you doing? Because I've already made the life virus. Okay, so those were programs, and somehow combining them makes them into a virus. That makes sense. Now we can delete. You mean, the end game is about to begin? Haha, of course. The final battle at last. Yahoot, come with me. Yes, that's his name, it's Yahoot. Yahoo with a T. As you command, so shall it be done. Is it easier to get shinies, or is that still annoying? Alright, I'm gonna say this, and this might be a spoiler, so if anyone else is listening to this, you might want to turn off, or mute the stream for like 30 seconds or so. But yeah, here it goes. It is slightly easier to get shinies and high EV or IV Pokemon, as well as hidden abilities, because in addition to the totem Pokemon, regular Pokemon are able to call in reinforcements. There's no more horde battles, just the reinforcement system. But the thing is, the reinforcement system can be used to summon, like, the more multiple Pokemon per battle, and the more you chain it, the more EVs you earn from them, the more experience you get from them, I think, and the more likely they are to have high IVs, be shiny, and have their hidden ability. So you can actually farm one Pokemon until you get it. Also, you can occasionally get, like, high evolution Pokemon without like, actually evolving them. Like, one person showed off a screenshot of them getting a level 10 Salamence by having a Bagon summon it. Including, and they also said, the same thing applies to, like, Dragonite, which is pretty funny because, if there's now level 10 Dragonites, that means that Lance's Dragonites from Red and Blue are no longer illegal. It means that he just went vacationing in Alola and caught the Dragonites there. Alright, that's all I'm saying on that, though. Lan, look on TV, it's awful. I am pleased to announce that the World 3 Master Plan is entering the final phase. Our next targets are this country's military satellites. We'll be launching a hacking rocket from our World 3 labs. Once we have control, the endgame begins. And we've got to get to the World 3 labs. Right on, let's go. Lan, where are you going at a time like this? We have to try to protect our home. Oh, honey, come home. It's mail from Dad. Must be about the World 3 lab location. I found the site of the World 3 lab deep in the mountains, but there's no roads or railways or no airport either. And it would take a long time to... It would take two with one O long to walk there, I'd reckon. But World 3 agents are getting into density somehow. Maybe we should ask that ex-member where the World 3 lab is. We've got more mail. More information on the Aura virus. Seems like the Aura always uses a type of energy. The one I met was fire, so I hit it with Aqua Tower. This seems to be an effective way to fight them. I'm afraid of war. We can't have a war. I'm not even married yet. Same, my duder. Same. When I got here, Higsby was taken by some strange men. They surrounded him and took off. Saw him drop something in the struggle. There's something by the register. Got a World 3 pass. A Metro Line pass. The World 3 and the Metro Line. Something fishy is going on here. The pass has expired. I'll bet Higsby was using it for the World 3. This is my auto chip sales machine, huh? You want to buy some chips, huh? But would it have barrier? That's a good question, actually. I don't know. Done better though. Anubis! Oh, that's a super rare chip right there. That only appears post game normally. Awesome that I got it from this. Set Anubis statue to reduce HP. What happens is when I use this, Anubis will appear on my side of the battlefield. It can be destroyed, but as long as it's in play, enemies constantly lose HP. It's a really good chip, and it's, you normally get it from a hidden boss. Let's ask if we could use that pass in the Metro Line. Grandpa, I'm coming to join you up there. Wow, that is depressing. That poor lady. Hey, anything I can help you with? Nah. Peh. Figures you and Mega Man don't have the guts. Then I'm gonna... Lan, please help us. I don't want to die in what is wrong with me today? Holy shit. A World 3 pass? You can't use that here. Watch me. Let me in. I don't have Hammer M. Conductor told me something interesting. Said that he could sometimes hear another train, even though no train is passing him. Could there be another train line running nearby? A secret metro line. That sounds suspicious. Let's check it out. So for a long time, I thought that one of these two houses where it says no one's home and no one's lived here for years, I thought that one of these two houses led to like a secret metro line. It turns out that none of these houses get used in any game. It's Trod. What's he doing here? I shouldn't be taking my time for my busy schedule now, but it looks like you need to learn a lesson. Looks like you need to learn a lesson. Just want to see how the probes do it, huh? Proto Man, you called. Having his chip would actually be really damn helpful right now. A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, If I recall, yep. I was like, wait, doesn't Proto Man re-steal if I steal? That sucks. It actually doesn't matter how well I do in this battle, because again, this is a Form 2 battle, I think. A Version 2 battle. After I beat him, Version 2 will become Version 3. Uh-oh. Wait, oh no, he only did one attack. Do I only have those three? H, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I don't have H? Really? No, that can't be right. This hit. Yeah, it does. Wrecked, son. Proto Man gets a lot harder in later games. But I didn't make any mistakes. What's in that Navi there? Let's take out a Number Man, put in Proto Man, hit the column with the nearest enemy. Yeah, that chip is way better in later games. In later games, he hits every enemy. But yeah, for the longest time, I thought the hidden train line was in those two houses or something. And I literally looked all over. It turns out it's right here. Whoosh. What was that noise? Came from below us, I wonder. The mystery metro line? Maybe there's an entrance around here somewhere. I could close up school if Miss Mari would just leave. No way, I'm staying with them. Yuri has gone off again, at a time like this. I'm the wandering chip collector. I'll trade with anyone who has something I want. Hoping I can find someone with an X-Panel 3S. Oh, I don't have that. That sucks. Yeah, I didn't trade with most of the people in this game. There's a door in the statue base. I think I can hear something. That sound, it's getting closer. Len, it's the metro line. Let's open the door. Len? I wonder what he's doing. A staircase? Let's go inside. Okay. Hey, Len! Wait up! Oh, he's gone. Huh? Did you just hear Mail's voice? Huh? I think you're hearing things. Hey, we found it. This sure does look like the World 3's secret metro line. We can get to the lab from here. Yeah, but our pass is out of date, Lan. Let's give it a try anyway. Nope, no good. Maybe we should ask your dad. Intruder alert. Leave the premises at once. Leave. Uh-oh. Let's get out of here, quick. So this is just under the school. Also, if Mail was still standing there, she wouldn't notice me. But is she here? Nope, she's gone. Conveniently. Also, if you remember the last stream of this, there was actually... oh, that's in the wrong area. there was actually an NPC that mentioned that a big chunk of the Metro Line's tracks were stolen. And the truth is, and that's what they were talking about. This, the secret Metro Line that World 3 built is from stolen tracks. I met one of the Ouroviruses too. Mine was wood, and it ignored any damage less than 80. I used the fire sword to delete it, but man, are they tough. They made an aura without an elemental affinity. It wouldn't have any weaknesses. A true life aura. Glad you're still okay. Was there something you need? I showed his dad the World 3 pass. We had heard rumors of the secret Metro line. Dad, can you make this thing work again? Sure, we just need to reset the expiration date. Beep, beep, boop. Like I said, piece of cake. Then got World 3 pass. Wow, the expiration date has changed. Thanks, Dad. It's funny how an evil organization has expiration dates on their train passes. Be careful, Lan. More mail. Rare chips. Has anyone met that virus that looks like a bagworm? Someone with a funny face. What is that guy's carrying a pretty rare chip? You meet him a lot if you go deep in the net. Bring... Dr. Hikari speaking. Oh, hello, honey. Yes, Lan was just here. I'm worried. I think those two are in trouble. Don't worry, I'll look out for them. I'll never let what happened last time happen again. Honey, I'm sorry to have called you at work. No, I'm sorry for not being home at home more. That is true. But it's okay. I'll be fine by myself here. Good, I'm glad to hear that. Bye. Dr. Hikari, I've got info on the virus in the World 3 rocket. It's the life virus. I see. Lan and Hub don't have a chance. Who the fuck is Hub? We've got to act fast. Can you help me? Yes, sir. We made it. So this is the World 3's lab, huh? Yeah, there's the hacking rocket. There's the hacking rocket. Let's break in. That liquid has got to be bad for the environment. Ack. Woo! It's Miss Yuri and the old man, Lan. I see them. Thank you, thank you, thank you. All you did was help me, and now... Heh, not at all. I'm used to hard times. Lan, you have to get up there quick. Roger, on my way. Keep it up. Don't let the World 3 get the best of you. Nah, I'm used to this. Don't worry about me. Let's go, huh? Want to challenge Higgs? Nah. That's right, huh? You gotta hurry on. It's securely locked. There seems to be a jack import here, though. Lan, I'll disable the lock. Mega Man, there's got to be a program locking this door. Find it and delete it. Roger. So we're in the final dungeon now. Admittedly, I'm a little underprepared for this compared to how I was, I think, the first time I played this game. Just because I didn't bother leveling up as much. Or powering up, rather. Time Bomb 3. I am a World 3 Navi. However, I can no longer help them. Please take this. It should help you. Got the Ice Block program. So this seems a little familiar. But yeah, you could probably tell just by this map, but this entire last dungeon is just kind of like a remixed area from all the earlier dungeons. Oddly enough, I think this is the only Battle Network game that actually does this. Battle Network 6 also does it. So the first Battle Network game and the last Battle Network game have the final area callback set up. Oh, that's not good. That hurts a lot. Yeah, maybe avoid doing that. Candle 2? I didn't even get Candle 1 anywhere, I don't think. Iron Shield. Hands are annoying as fuck because they have so much HP. Fuck. Damn, that took a long time. I still got an Iron Shield out of it. Almost blew that. Please tell me I had enough to get through here. Not enough ice blocks. I can see the program right there. Leave it to us. Yai, what are you doing here? I'll explain later. Glide to work. Interesting fact, Glide, for some reason, has his name changed to have it spelled with a Y to an I in, like, every later game, I think. I think this is the only game where his name is spelled with a Y. Certainly, my lady. The rest is up to you. Thanks, I owe you one. You did it. Thanks, Yai. Just helping out a friend. Be careful. How did she get here? Like, did Lan's father make new passes or whatever? Mail told me to give this to you. Roll 3. Don't lose it now. It's securely locked. You know it's a jack import. Second digit increased. All right. Passcode too low. Second digit, so it's got to be 889. Uh-oh, it's the Aura Virus. Shit. Also, every Navi's chip code is generally the first letter of their first name, like Rolls R. Notice how Protoman is B, because his Japanese name is Blues. Jesus. Ow. Whew. Close one. These are all just guessing passwords. Passcode too high. Passcode too low. Passcode too high. Wait, what? Too low, second digit, alright. God, this thing's fucking me up harder than... Really? God, I hadn't saved in a while, too. Yep. Son of a bitch. Alright. God, I can't believe I gotta go through all that over again. Why didn't I save? Idiot. Holy shit. That's why the Anubis chip is awesome. Totally legit. Yeah, yeah. Always save. I fucked up. I fucked up. I fucked up bad. See, I beat both of those with an S rank, and I still didn't get their chip. Getting their chip is so hard. I don't know why. I hit the wrong button. See, I thought that the aura thing had a limit of like 3 spaces for its attack, but it can actually just go the entire length of the battle arena. Alright, now we're back to where we were. It's like I never even missed it. Oh, you fucks. They broke my chip. Unbelievable. Give me the damn howitzer chip. I don't even know what I'm doing anymore. That's a lock program. Well, let's go back the other way real quick. Oh no, I can't reach the entire length of the arena. I could go one square less. Fighter Sword P. A B. And definitely have more B's than P's in here, so just forget it. How'd that not even... really? Mega Man, do your stuff. Huh? No good. This passcode is gonna take some time. Leave it to me. Mr. Higsby? Numbers are no problem for Number Man. Analyzing program. Passcode 9630. Entering passcode. Thanks, Number Man. Lan, get going. I'm gone. Higsby has had a change of heart and is now doing his best to help you, as am I. Now I load this onto the rocket and... report, sir, it seems that intruders are in the lab. Grr, I won't be stopped now. Yahoot, deal with them. As you command, so shall it be done. Just a little more and the world will be... deleted. Say your prayers, Dr. Hikari. Wipe out the World 3, huh? That's right, you gotta hurry on. Securely locked, jack and port, let's go. Water area, we know what's next, it's the water area. Double. Got the double. Big bomb B. A power-up program would be cool. All that did was remove an ore. Great. bears. Recover 300. Hold on a sec, that didn't feel right. Yeah, I knew it. Darn, this is a tough program. Let us help you. What? Freud? I got a lot of making up to do to you. Iceman, yes sir. Thanks, Iceman. Let's get Wily. Right on. Good luck. I know you could do it. Please save us. I'll help you anytime. Alright, I could challenge him too. I've completely forgot. Skull. Very ominous. Skull. It's securely locked, but there's a jack in port. Who could have guessed? Anything hidden over here? Nope. Let's go continue forward then. If I had picked my chips in a different order, I almost would have been dead by now. Nah, I'm not gonna get impatient like that now. Probably won't last long, but whatever. Or never mind, actually killed him. Works, that Anubis works really fast in this game. In other games, it drains a little slower, I think. Ugh, why are you doing this to me? So I'm pretty sure going that way. Or not. Well, I don't know. Fuck. Hold on. See, because now I don't know which way is the right way and which way is the wrong way. Now I'd like to go the wrong way first so I can get whatever goodies are down it. That's always how these games work. Or enemies, please. Thunder 2. All that for a time bomb, great. You know what? It was worth it. It was a good experience. I got an HP memory. Was hoping for a power-up. That would have been nice to get. So I could increase one of my parameters one more time. Those two viruses overlap for a second there. Wow. You fuck. Come on. Hold on, don't forget about us. Dex, leave the hard parts to me and Gutsman. We'll handle this. Hmm? You sure you can do it? Trust me, you should save your strength for the last battle. Yo, Gutsman. Dunna. I'm sorry. I had to do it. Thanks, Gutsman. Yeehaw. Dex, you really came through. Of course, silly, but it's not over yet. You're right. Okay, I'm off. But I wonder how you all knew how to come here. Nothing beats being Guts. Good luck, Lan. We're all counting on you. I'll take you on anytime you're ready. Lan, you've got mail. Did you all see the World 3 broadcast? Things are getting pretty sticky. I got some info on the Life Virus from my lab connections. I thought all Netbattlers should know about this. Life Virus, ultimate virus made up of four programs, Fire, Aqua, Elec, and Wood, possessing no elemental weakness. No effective strategies known. That's what it says. Honestly, I don't know how my net navy could fight it. I've got some other info here. Apparently there's evidence that the Life Virus defense program was copied by someone. Something that has to do with the World 3 or the Endgame? Who knows? All we could do is practice with our chips and wait. Even more securely locked than the other door so far. And no jack-in port either. This machine makes a high buzzing sound. What could be plugged into this huge outlet? That's not right, because that's the plug. It's what kind of outlet could this huge plug be plugged into, or whatever. Plans for the World 3 plot. All of their schemes are outlined in these documents. The screen is filled with data. It's the Master Control Center for the World 3. You're not sure what this machine is for. Nothing good, you assume. A self-portrait of Wily. Hey, Lan, check out all these footprints. Hey, yeah. Let's check around here again. You notice that the picture swings back. Man, it's a secret door. Cool, we could jack in here. The program that's locking the door should be near. Find it and delete it. Yeah, this is a pretty long dungeon. Bubble Wrap 3. The Bubble Wrap chips in the later games are really broken. Because in this game, it's like, you get the bubble wrap for a little bit. In Battle Network 2, you get it permanently. And what it does is every time it gets popped, it'll come back after a few seconds. So you essentially have infinite barriers. You just have to be patient. You just have to be able to dodge attacks while it's popped. But in this game, it's, like, limited. Like, each one only lasts a certain amount of time. Or pops a certain amount of times before, it disappears. Lock on one. Don't think I have that yet. Big wave K. Be careful. When you fight the world 3 Navi, your Navi save feature will be disabled. You may want to save here. It's close. Very close. Essentially, they're saying, after this, no saving. Weird. I can't use any batteries here. For real? Not after we made it so far. Man, I'm here at last. Male, you too? What's going on here? Roll. Hi, Omega. What are you all doing here? I saw you near the school entrance, and I told everyone to come. So we all came to help out. Man, I was doing fine by myself. Yeah, right, is that any way to show gratitude? Really, roll. Roll out. Oh, that's a cute fun. Yep. Roll Flash, which she never uses in any other game. Thanks, Roll. We did it. You take care of yourself, Mega. Sure thing. Now land. Thank Mail. Humph. Nobody asked her to. Mail. What now? Thanks. You really saved me. Thanks to all of you guys. Oh? Land. I was so worried. Sorry. I meant to be cheering you on, not crying. Also, that sniff hurt my nose. Fuck. Good luck, land. Mail. Leave it to me. I'm jacking out. Wait! Sorry to interrupt such a touching scene. But this is as far as I can allow you to go. Who are you? I am Yahoot, right-hand man to Wily of the World 3. And I am his Navi, Magic Man. And for my next trick... I hate this fight. If I remember, this fight's really annoying. He summons viruses. However, he doesn't move from that spot. He'll just dodge under, and that'll be it. Don't steal. We don't need to steal. Okay, he's down. See, the nice thing is that if that tornado thing just stays on that platform, he can't summon another enemy there. It does look pretty cool. Compared to his Mega Man, like, classic form, Magic Man looks pretty cool. I forget what game he's in. Is he Mega Man in base? I think so. Also, as far as I could tell, he's the only Navi boss that could summon other Navis. Or other enemies, rather. Oh, and Lightning doesn't even focus on the other enemies. That kind of sucks. Not doing good. Oh, I'm getting right fucked. Hold on. Just hold out a couple more seconds. Got him. We did it. Ugh. Yahoo, not you too. Here, use this bit data from the life virus. Phew. Life. Magic, huh? Ugh. Yahoo, I did it. You can say goodbye to Megaman.exe. No. The Magic Man, look out. Life matter? Gah, too late? Mega. Lan, your father gave me this. Here. Hub.bat, what's this? Emergency, receiving call. Hello? Lan, Dad, Mega Man's... Dr. Hikari, I'm sorry, I was too late. Lan, listen to me. You could still save Mega Man. But he's not responding. Apply the hub.bat to Mega Man. There may still be time. But before you use it, I have to tell you something. It might make it hard for you to use Mega Man, okay? I don't really understand what you mean, but I'll do anything if it might save Mega Man. Then listen. About 10 years ago, I was working on a new kind of Navi. A kind of Navi that could truly befriend its operator. But a program is only a program. Though I can make a Navi follow its operator's orders, I couldn't make one think and act on its own. So I started thinking, maybe if you had some connection with your Navi, the Navi could respond to your emotions, and thereby create its own emotions. So I tried. Looking at human DNA, human, I said it with a Y in there, I came to a conclusion. If I made a Navi with DNA just like its operator's, its basic values and emotions would be the same. Operator and Navi would become a single entity, making an ultimate Navi. But it was tough making a program with DNA. I can make about 95% of the program, but no more. I just couldn't figure out that last 5%. My research came to a sudden stop. It was around then I had a son, a cute baby boy. We named him Hub. But our happiness didn't last long. He had heart trouble and became too weak to live. So I thought, somehow, I'll keep his memory alive. Lan, Hub was your twin brother. You were both born from the same egg. Your DNA is identical. I could use Hub's DNA to make a Navi for you. Suddenly, I had the DNA solution I had been searching for. The Navi I made was Mega Man. And the results proved that I was right. Mega Man is a new generation of Navi, as close to you as a brother. But there was a danger. If I made the DNA 100% the same, Navi's internal and external state might sync with you, so damage to the Navi would damage you, too. So I changed Mega Man's DNA. So I changed Megaman.exe's DNA by 0.001%. If you use the hub.bat, that 0.001% will disappear. You mean Mega Man will be reborn again? As my twin? Correct. I was always sending Mega Man into such dangerous places. Did Mega Man... Hub, know the truth? I asked Hub to keep it a secret. If you knew the truth, you'd be too scared to use him. And a Navi that you can't use isn't a good Navi. This seems like kind of weird and morally gray. It's like, yeah, your brother's a computer program, but go ahead and send him into dangerous places. Because that's what Navis are supposed to do. It's weird. So what will you do? I'll let you decide. But Hub, I'll lose Mega Man. Remember, if your DNA is 100% the same, you will be affected by whatever affects your Navi. And the reverse is true, too. Len, if you truly think you can beat the World 3, I think Hub will sense that, and he'll come back to help. Okay, I'll use the Hub.bat. Len, you're doing the right thing. Applying Hub.bat to Megaman.exe. Hub, come fight by my side. No reply. Hmm? Lan. Hub. It's me, Lan. Wake up. Lan? Ugh. What happened to me? Hub, it's you. Lan, you called me Hub? Hub, I've told Lan everything. We used Hub.bat to bring you back. Dad, I see. That light means your program is being rewritten. When the light goes down, your power should be increased. Yeah, I could feel the energy inside me. Lan, I'm sorry for not telling you the truth earlier. Hub, I'm sorry for ordering you around all these years. No problem. I always regretted not being able to be with you in the real world, but being able to watch you from inside here, it made me happy. Hub, so how do I operate you now, I wonder? Just be yourself. I'll be myself. Mega Man. Let's hurry. Lan, I'm counting on you. Right, okay. Let's go, Mega Man. Right on. Mega Man, I'm so glad to see you. No need for thanks. I'm just keeping you around for entertainment value. It's like you know that he's a human, and you're still saying like, oh, the only reason I haven't killed you is because I'm amused. Good luck, Lan. I know you can do it. You could do anything you set your mind to. You again. Why are you always in my way? Smart call on your part. I can't save now. I don't think I could leave either. The door locks. Land, do the secret door, quick. Yeah, no. I'll bet this room is connected to where the rocket is. Do I have anything, like, super that I haven't put in my deck yet? Because I could really use it right now. Barrier, bubble wrap. Let's put in bubble wrap. Place a high cannon with it. Oh, excuse me. Have any other Invis chips? Invis 2. I should probably put those in as well. Anubis won't last long in this final battle, so I'll take that out. Dash can be taken out too. Can't save. I don't think it shows it, but now I think all my stats are 6. Like, they're even higher than you can normally go. You can normally go up to 5. Now I think my attack is 6, my rapid is 6, and my charge is also 6. There he is. There's Dr. Wawi. Once I press this button, bye-bye world. Dr. Hikari may have kicked me out of his little lab, but now I get my revenge. Wait, Wily. Ah, Hikari's little boy Lin, I presume. Leave it to the Hikaris to bother me to the very end. The end game is revenge against my family? Why? Shall I tell you? 30 years ago, 2 famous scientists competed to be the best. Me and your grandfather, Dr. Hikari. I made robots, and Hikari specialized in networks. We were both lost to our research. Then one day, in order to win an international competition, our country had to pick one of our projects to fund. After long debate, they canceled my robot research. I couldn't believe it. My research was vital. Vital! I had no place to turn to, and so I left the lab. That's why I'm mad, if it wasn't for Hikari. So I made the World 3 to get back at him. He made this world what it is, and now I'll destroy it. But he didn't cancel your research. It's not his fault. Huh, that's what he said, too. You'll never understand how I feel. Never! Enough talk. World, prepare for deletion. No. Haha. Never. Not if Mega Man and I can help it. So essentially, this is an alternate version of the classic Mega Man series, only instead of both Dr. Wily and Dr. Light working on robots, only Dr. Wily did. Instead, Dr. Light worked on networking, which led to all this internet shit. And that's why Dr. Wily created this organization now to get back at Dr. Hikari, which, if you don't know, Hikari is Japanese for light. So it's supposed to be Dr. Light. In fact, in one of the other games, you actually see Dr. Light, or Dr. Hikari, the grandfather, and it looks like Dr. Light from the classic series. So anyway, with that out of the way, Mega Man, we have to do what we can to help everyone. I don't have any escape chips, so it's very well possible I can die here. Giant snake. I think this thing shows up in the internet somewhere. Can't remember what it attacks with. That's like nothing. Oh yeah, right. Yep, I do 6 damage per shot. So yeah, all my buster stats have been upgraded to 6. Lan. The life virus. If we could delete it, the World 3's plans will be foiled. This is it. Our ultimate virus bashing. Battle routine set. Execute. Final boss time. What do I want to use? Let's go with Fireman for now. Gotta see what he does. So he has 100 aura, which means the only way to hurt him is to do 100 damage or more first to remove the aura, then I can attack him. But if I wait until right before he attacks, he drops the aura to attack. This boss is really easy, because the only thing he can do is, like, charge and attack and run and summon these, like, little bugs. As far as I can tell, he only has the laser and the swing attack, neither of which are all that hard to avoid. Those little bugs are actually regular enemies in a later Battle Network game. That's that. My life virus! What have you done? My baby! My World 3! No! Warning, warning. Virus leak. All systems malfunctioning. Self-destruct sequence activated. Because of course there's a self-destruct sequence in a Capcom game. Uh-oh. But my precious World 3 laboratory! Let's get out of here, Mega Man. Check out. Roger. Lan. Lan, are you okay? Hey, guys. And the life virus? History. Yippee! Where's everyone else? They got away to safety. Great, now let's scram. Hurry, the place is gonna blow! World 3, forever! And so... Good job, Lan and Hub. I mean, Mega Man. Oh, I'm so glad the two of you are okay. Sorry, Mom. Well, I never thought raising two boys was going to be easy. Isn't that right, honey? Heh, they couldn't have done it without you. Thanks. They couldn't have done it without us, you mean. Honey? Honey? Your mom and dad sure get along well, Lan. I know, it's really embarrassing. Maybe we can learn from them. Huh? What are you talking about? We're just friends. Lan. He really is dense, isn't he? That's right, Roll. You said it, Mega. Look, even Roll and Mega Man are in the mood. I've had it with you, Lan, after I was so nice. I shouldn't have rescued you after all. I don't get it, what am I doing wrong? Yowza. Woo! Mail and Lan up in a tree. Well, that's not even how it goes. Mail and, huh? Mail, are you... Do you... Isn't it obvious, really? Yeah, but I... Don't deny it, Lan. Good, that's it. This conversation is over. Just thanks for rescuing me, you two. Dex always pays his debts. Always pays his debts. Don't mention it. Thanks, Dex. You're a true friend. That's right. You need a little more practice, though, Dex. What was that? Me? Practice? Why, you... Well, now, aren't we all the happy bunch now? Chaw, thanks. You really helped out, too. No need to thank me. In fact, you made me look pretty bad. Because you did all the work. Grumpy as ever, I see. But I couldn't have stopped the World 3 if you hadn't helped. Thank you. Yeah, well, thanks accepted this time. But next time something happens, you leave the fighting up to me and Proto Man. Hey, we'll be right by your side, right, Mega Man? Ah, sorry, I mean, if you still want to, Hub? Mega Man's the name, and I'm with you all the way. As a team, Lan, we're unstoppable. Yeah, right. Oh, wait. Just one thing. From now on, you're getting up by yourself in the morning. Got it? What? Really? Ahuga, ahuga. I think it's supposed to be like that horn noise. What? There can't be a crook here now. The alarm system must be buggy again. Darn old thing. Lan, we've got a job to do. Right on, let's go. Jack in. Megaman.exe, transmit. It's ridiculous how easy the end of that game is compared to how annoying it is to actually go through the dungeon. Fun. It was fun to replay that game. Makes me almost want to replay the other ones too. Maybe I will someday on stream. I don't know. Battle Network 2 is definitely a game I would love to revisit at some point because it's my favorite out of the series, and I've also only played through the story once. I wish Gutsman could have been there during that dungeon to fix those roads for me. That would have been great. Also, I noticed Mr. Match is standing on top of the blue wire there, which is impossible. Also, ignore that scene. That is most certainly not canon. Mega Man cannot beam into the real world in this game. 81 out of 175 chips. Not bad. Only took me 10 hours in game time. And now you're thrown back to the title, and you get a neat little... You get a neat little star next to continue, which lets you do post-game shit. I don't think you get any new emails, but now you essentially just can leave and get everything you missed and do the hidden areas and shit. I'm probably not even gonna bother, because even getting to the first hidden boss takes hours of gameplay from this point. In fact, to fight the final hidden boss, you need every chip in here but one. All but this chip right here, the four roll. Because the way you get it is by getting every other chip in the game, and there's a lot in this game. I'm gonna improve our equipment when we're done. Let's get back going to the World 3 Labs. So yeah, that's that. But I will I'll show off the other bosses, the hidden bosses in this game. Right after. You know who's not in this game, but is in the second game. It's Magnet Man. And you know. You know what Mega Man is.
Excellent, Mega Man. If all humans were as smart as you, I wouldn't have to bother with these nasty invasions.
Yeah, it's good to have you on the bad side, Mega Man.
All right, Magnet Dude. Give me five.
He's getting my powers!
I don't know why I find this so goddamn amusing. I'll be annotating the video to get back to that. What am I doing here? Alright. Yeah, I was gonna show off the, other bosses, Pharaoh Man, MMBN, Bibibinbin, Secret Boss Pharaoh Man. No, we don't want Battle Network 2, we want Battle Network 1. That's whatever. This is the first hidden boss. I forget what area he's in. It really doesn't matter because he appears so... Wow, that's loud. I'll remember to replay that video if I do Battle Network 2 when I get up to Magnet Man. But yeah, it really doesn't matter where these bosses are located because, you know, the internet looks the same everywhere you go in this game. But you could at least check them out. I'm not bothering to go for them because that'll take me hours just to get to Pharaoh Man. Also, I don't know why the audio is like double. What is this guy recording this on? So he gets lasers, he could drop rocks, he could use little snakes, or was that Mega Man that did that? Whatever. Not too difficult. Also, he in addition to his own chips, he drops, yeah, Pharaoh Trap. If you step on that, something happens, I guess. He drops his chips, and he also drops the Anubis chip that I got from the chip thingy. Second hidden boss is Shadow Man. Split himself into copies, he throws shurikens at you, and he does like that weird move that just makes an explosion appear. Again, I'm not bothering to do the post-game for this because, there's no story tied to it at all. It's just literally go through these extra areas, fight some extra bosses, and enjoy some new chips and shit. In Battle Network 2 and beyond, though, doing the post-game might be necessary, just because there is story related to it. In fact, in Battle Network 2, all of these hidden bosses are related to the story. Pharaoh Man is in the post-game, and Shadow Man, and the last one I'm going to show you, are part of the main story. And finally, the final hidden boss. This is the one that's a complete pain in the ass to fight. There's, like, no good video of his, like, Battle Network 1 version. So this is Bass from Mega Man 7 and Mega Man 8 and Mega Man and Bass. He has an aura, a life aura, which blocks all damage under 100, just like the final boss. He can regenerate it quickly, and unlike the other one, unlike the Life Virus, he actually does not drop it before he attacks, so you have to remove it and then attack him. He's also incredibly difficult, because these attacks will do like 300 damage each if they hit you. This guy's going to destroy him quickly because he has a bunch of good chips, but... completely wrecked him. He does not drop his own chip. He only drops a chip called he drops the Life Aura chip that Mega Man was using there. The only difference is that, he just drops the Life Aura chip. One second. And that's pretty much it. I mean, I don't really, think there's anything else to do here. I mean, I don't want to do any of the post-game shit. So it's a little earlier than I usually end my stream, but I guess I'll cut it here since I beat the game. Yeah, Bass is pretty fucking rough. In fact, hold on one second. Let me see. Let me just, it's gonna just take a minute. Okay. Nope, not yet. Where am I going here? Documents. Well, first things first, let me save the game. Then report. Alright, I imported a save. This is the very last area of the internet. It's just a big block of nothing. This guy has every chip. He even has the base chip. Wow. Explodes an entire area. And he's got the life orb. Negate attacks with damage under 100. It's pretty cool. Level 100, he's got all the armors. No more emails. I don't think there's any items here that you don't already have. What's he got in his folder? Oh, he's got bait. Wow, look at all those hero swords. So let's just, for shits and giggles, see if I can beat Face. I mean, I probably can with these ultra powerful chips and shit, but there he is. All right. Just to show how immensely powerful he is. Like, look, I have 100,000 health. One hit, does 200 damage. That does 300. I think he has one more, too. Yeah, he has like the actual firing attack, which also does 200. It's pretty ridiculous. Oh, he does drop it to a... Oh, that was the other attack he does. Yeah. That does 300 damage per hit. Like I said, not an incredibly easy boss. So he does drop the aura when he does a charge shot. Spoiler alert, he's actually even harder in later games than he is in this one. Of course, you know, I'm wrecking him because I have good chips, but like, in a normal situation, most people probably wouldn't have a folder like this. Gives no fucks. Five, and I got a life orb chip. Not bad. But yeah, he doesn't actually drop his own chip. It was originally thought that the only way to get it is by, like, going to, like, an event. Because, you know, Capcom was doing the same thing that, like, Pokemon would do with, like, event chips and shit like that. But it turns out that this game's chip trader, that blue one that you put 10 chips in, if you do it enough, there's a chance you could get the base chip. Actually never got it in my own copy, but whatever. I mean, there it is right there. Explodes an entire area. Yeah, that's pretty cool. I mean, also, I just realized this is 177 out of 176, which isn't right. There's no chip beyond 176. I mean, what happened was the person who made this file probably cheated to get all the chips, and there is a dummy chip that you can't get in the game, and that's probably why it says there's 177 chips registered. As opposed to 176. Because in-game it says 175 until you actually get base's chip. Then it adds the extra slot to the bottom. Anyway, I've dragged this out long enough now. I think that it's a safe time to end the stream. I will be streaming again most likely tomorrow. If not tomorrow, then definitely Thursday. And that'll be it for the week. Tomorrow I'm planning on doing the first of two Sega Genesis one-off streams. Tomorrow I'm going to be doing a game that's kind of related to, I'm not going to say Pokemon directly, but it kind of does have like a connection to it. It's a game that I've wanted to play for a while, and I'm hoping I could beat it in a single stream. And if I do, that'll be good. And then next week, on either Monday or Tuesday, and this will be the only stream next week because I'm most likely not going to be here Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday. It's going to be another Genesis game, which is not really related to anything in particular, aside from the fact that, you know, you eat turkeys on Thanksgiving, and there's a bird in the game I'm gonna play. That's it. But yeah, so expect some Sega Genesis shit over the next week, essentially. Tomorrow and either next Monday or next Tuesday. Thanks for coming by. Let me see, is anyone else streaming right now? Not really. Is there even anyone to host? No, alright. Alright then. Thanks for coming, everyone. You have a good evening.